this video, you'll learn about the important role shutter speed plays in not only correctly exposing your shot, but also in achieving the much sought-after film look on a mobile device through its impact on motion blur, and how you can set this manually using FiLMiC Pro with the Moondog Labs Filter Kit for pretty incredible results. If you're an iPhone filmmaker, you've probably already heard of Moondog Labs as they make the anamorphic lens that was used to shoot the award-winning iPhone 5S shot feature film Tangerine, and now they make a range of premium quality neutral density and polarizer filters that they were kind enough to send out for testing. I received the 52mm filter mount for the Moondog anamorphic lens, which is fitted by loosening the screw, sliding it over the lens, and tightening to secure. As it comes with a lens cap, you can leave it on permanently, which is a nice touch. But you don't have to use the filters with the Moondog anamorphic lens. There are mounting options for GoPros, iPro lens systems, Moment lenses, as well as camera mounts like the B-Script Pro and Iographer. I also received an ND 4, 8 and 16, plus a polarizer filter. If you're unfamiliar with what ND stands for, it's short for neutral density, and they're designed to reduce the amount of light entering the lens without changing the color characteristics. An ND4 reduces light by one stop, the 8x2, the 16x3, and so on. They use a 52mm thread and can be screwed directly onto your mount of choice. Now let's get back to shutter speed and why it matters. For DSLR and video cameras, the shutter speed makes up one part of what's called the exposure triangle, along with aperture and ISO. And the photographer or videographer uses an interplay of all three of these to achieve correct exposure and the desired look. The shutter speed determines how long each frame of your video is exposed for and is measured in fractions of a second, for example, 1/48th of a second. And you can use the shutter speed to control the motion blur or lack thereof in your shot. The aperture relates to how open or closed your lens's iris is. The wider the aperture, the more light that is let into your camera's sensor, and as this is stopped down, the amount of light captured is decreased. Lastly, the ISO adjusts the electrical sensitivity of your sensor. But as this is an electrical adjustment, it introduces digital noise that can look ugly as the sensitivity is increased to capture more light. As we're shooting on a smartphone, adjusting the aperture on our lens isn't an option, as this is fixed due to the tiny size of the lens, thus depriving us of a very useful exposure and depth of field control. This leaves us with just shutter speed and ISO to control our exposure. Most of the time, smartphone videographers let the app automatically set both of these values for them. In FiLMiC Pro or any other video app with manual controls, when we drag our exposure reticle to set our exposure, the app automatically selects the best combination of ISO and shutter speed to correctly expose for that point in our frame, and we hit record without actually checking to see what these values are. If I tap and hold on the exposure reticle to open the manual adjustment slider, you can see that if we check our settings in sunny outdoor conditions, we have the lowest possible ISO value, which is great as it will produce the cleanest image. However, if I tap the shutter icon, you can see that to correctly expose this scene, a shutter speed of anywhere between 1/2000th to 1/4000th of a second is used. Why is this a problem? Well, the shutter speed has a direct impact on the quality of motion in your shot. If you want the most film-like motion blur, then you should always set your shutter speed so that it's double your frame rate. If you're shooting at 24 frames per second, then you want a shutter speed of 1/48th of a second. If you're shooting at 25, then 1/50th is ideal, and so on. If you're wondering where this rule comes from, it can be traced back to film cameras which since the advent of synchronized sound have always shot at 24 frames per second and use a physical 180-degree shutter, which meant that each frame of the film was only exposed for 1/48th of a second. As the cinema-going public has become accustomed to this, we've been conditioned to perceive this as normal, and as a result, we associate it with the film look. Here is a shot I filmed at 30 frames per second with a shutter speed of 1/60th, and you can see we get nice natural motion blur. And if I freeze the frame, this motion blur becomes obvious. Here is the same shot filmed with a shutter speed of 1/500th of a second. You can see that we lose the smooth motion blur and we get a much sharper yet more jittery shot. If we freeze frame, you can see how much sharper the motion is on a frame by frame basis. Lastly, here's the same shot with a shutter speed of 1/2000th of a second. Each individual frame is even sharper as it's only being exposed for 1/2000th of a second. This is great if shooting sporting events where you want to be able to extract ultra sharp still images, but in terms of its representation of motion, it just isn't what we associate with the film look. However, if I simply reduce my shutter speed to 1/60th of a second in FiLMiC Pro in daylight conditions, the shot is completely blown out even with the lowest ISO selected, and not having a lens with manual aperture we can step down, we have no choice but to shoot at an incredibly high shutter speed to achieve correct exposure. And this is why ND filters are invaluable for bright conditions. If I attach the ND16, I reduce the amount of light entering the iPhone lens by 3 stops, and can lock in the perfect shutter speed to achieve beautiful filmic motion even in sunny conditions. The great thing about the Moondog ND filters is that you can screw multiple filters together to cut out even more light. So that is ND filters in a nutshell. Incredibly powerful for all filmmakers, but especially for smartphone filmmakers who are deprived of one element of the exposure triangle, namely aperture, but who want to capture the cinematic motion blur that results by maintaining the correct relationship between frame rate and shutter speed. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe to Epic Tutorials for more. And I've linked to Moondog Labs in the description if you want to find a filter kit for your shooting setup, as well as a link to FiLMiC Pro on the App Store if you want a professional video solution for iOS or Android. My name's Elliot Fitzroy, and you can connect with me on Snapchat, Instagram, and Twitter to talk smartphone media production, and I'm happy to answer any questions in the comments field below. Thanks a lot for watching.